the USWA Broadcast Center. Hello once again, everyone. Michael St. John here for USWA Wrestling. Today on the program, we'll discuss the USWA World Tag Team Championship belts. As you well know, the Southern Rockers have made an outstanding debut in the USWA, and the stud stable has been victimized, as they put it, but yet they have recaptured the belts. We'll go into all that momentarily. Also, a big signing, big announcement, the return of handsome Jimmy Valiant. The flamboyant one is coming to the USWA. Also in action, we'll have superstar Bill Dundee, Jeff Jarrett, and many, many more. Mark Lawrence at the Sportatorium in Dallas will tell us all about it, and we'll get into the action right after these messages.
Exciting team of the Southern Rockers, Steve Dahl and Rex King. And you're going to see a couple of pieces of tape here, eight pieces of tape featuring a couple of very successful endeavors for the Rockers, who then get severely baited and agitated by the stud stable.
The Rockers double up.
That's an illegal move.
Ryan Lee's shoulders down.
Oh,
got
a
one, two.
$1,000, we're willing to take $1,000.
Hey, what about my match? I'm just supposed to wrestle now. Look out!
All four of them. Now Fuller slides out under the rope, so the referee.
Save him!
Look at Fuller loading up that boot. Could you see him? Oh, blocked! The Rockers!
Hey, wait a minute!
Fuller shoulders down. No. Got him! They beat him again! They beat him again.
Give me that money.
They get the $1,000 and they keep the belt.
No, he wasn't a legal man. Wait a minute.
Yes, sir. Take the money. Take the belt.
Man. That's it. That looks like a couple of gamblers out there. Come
hey,
on, boys.
Make them
gamble.
Make them put that other $1,000 up against it. Yeah.
Why don't you stay out of it, for heaven's sake? They've already got the $1,000 won. You guys have got the $1,000 on the belt. They've got $2,000 here.
Y'all do not have to put the belts up again. You've already put them up one time. This is the toughest team in the area since they had the belts. It's not necessary for you to put the belts up. You don't have to put them up.
We'll tell you what, Mr. Marlin. The Rockers, we ain't backing down from nobody. And to tell you one thing, if that $2,000 was as easy as taking the last $1,000, we'll be more than happy to get back in the game.
Like the man said,
if you got the money, we got the time, baby. I'm
telling you. Here's the money.
Everybody in the ring again. Don't try to say it's two against one. It's two against two. Rex King flips over the rope. Drives the rope. Drives our Brian Lee. Turns around. He's pressed down to the mat. Turn around, referee. Starts to count. Fuller loads up the boot and nails him in the top of the head. Now Fuller slides out of the ring. And Brian Lee has a cover. Count of one, two. He had his feet on the rope. It's a count of three. You see his feet on the rope there?
I don't think you did either.
I sure did. Brian Lee got the three count, though. And thrown over the top rope is Steve Dahl by Robert Fuller. There's a pile driver by Brian Lee. Well, here they come. They're going to grab the belt. And they're going to run out of here. They were beaten twice, fair and square, in the middle of the ring. But then Brian Lee and Robert Fuller, Fuller with that loaded up right boot. Again, stomping him in the midsection. Steve Dahl lying here on the floor. Now Fuller comes around, collects the money. Collects the belt.
That's all there. Dave didn't get none of it.
Yeah, what is that fair and square you guys were out here talking about earlier? Celebrate. You were beaten twice.
Comes Robert Fuller of the Tennessee Stud Stable, and it's time to talk tag team excitement and the Southern Rockers.
Before I get into any Southern Rockers, I got something I want to say to this whole bunch of goofs out here in this crowd. I came out here just 1 week ago with a heavy heart. I had something bothering me, and I saw in 1 second why I hate you people the way that I do. You don't care about nothing out there. Well, I'm going to tell you something, and I'm going to tell you, Mr. Commentator, and you go tell the promoter in the back, you tell him to tell the matchmaker, and then go tell that good-for-nothing official of yours. I don't like none of them. And you want me to go off on you, Dad? I can go off on you, because I'm the Tennessee War Machine, baby. Now, we got us a deal going here when we're hunting for the prettiest lady in the world. I don't expect to find her in this crowd. Shut up! But we are going to find the loveliest girl in the country. We're going to find somebody with guts. We're going to find somebody that don't mind getting on that bus and being ready to ride. And then we're going to go on with a great tradition, and that's victories. And you ask me about these rockers. We take these rockers, boy, for our morning breakfast and eat them alive. They're nothing to us.
Well, now, wait a minute. According to the tape we just saw, they won two straight times.
What tape?
The tape that we've just shown the folks here on television.
I come out here and you show that tape? Let me tell you something. The day that we did... Shut up! The day that we did that tape was the same day that I had a problem. I had a problem with my wife leaving me.
So
I'm not 100%. Brian come in and said, Robert, I got a stomachache. I said, don't worry about it. I'll go in, problems or nothing, and carry the thing. They caught us on an off day. But if you watch that tape closely, who's got the belt? Who's standing here right now? Look at this. I'm going to tell you something, Southern Rockers, and you think long and heavy about it, Daddy, that I'm going to make you true Southern Rockers because I got a grandma who lives way down south in Alabama. I'm going to break both your legs. I'm going to get Brian to help me work you over. We're going to send you down to Grandma's in the rocking chair, and you'll be true Southern Rockers. Know what I mean?
Do I detect some worry in Robert Fuller's voice? I believe so. The Stud Stable are going to have their hands full with the Southern Rockers. We'll see the Rockers in action right after these messages from the USWA. The USWA presents wrestling action Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum. $1 off all tickets, 5 great matches. Opening action, the Soul Taker takes on Ben Jordan. You'll see Wild Side Chris Champion against Rockin' Randy. Dirty Dutch Mantel takes on the Dirty White Boy. In a return, USWA Tag Team Championship match. No time limit, no disqualification. The match is signed for Evansville Wednesday night. The Stud Stable, Robert Fuller and Brian Lee, battle the Southern Rockers Steve Dahl and Rex King. 6-man tag action, a grudge main event. Jerry the King Lawler, Hot Property Billy Joe Travis, and the Beauty Terrence Garvin take on Jeff Jarrett, Superstar Bill Dundee, and Handsome Jimmy Valiant. Plus, wrestling action March 4th, Princeton, Kentucky at the Caldwell County Middle School, and Thursday, March 15th in Cloverport, Kentucky. Don't miss the great action, Evansville Coliseum, Wednesday night, $1 off all tickets.
Hey, Billy Travis, we're talking about, excuse me, Billy Joe Travis. I love to get that middle name in there. We're talking about a big 6-man tag team match that's coming up this week right here in this town. And I want to ask you if you know what this is I got in front of me.
No, what is that, Kingfish?
This, and look at this baby.
Wow,
this,
that's long.
That's long, all right. Look at them prices on there. This is Jeff Jarrett's long-distance telephone bill where he has obviously been calling all around the country. Every wrestler can get his hands on.
What's that last number?
That last number is where he finally got themselves a partner that had the guts to come in here and face you, myself, and gorgeous Terrence Garvin. And who is it? None other than...
Mercy, Daddy! Who do you think that is?
Handsome Jimmy. Well, I got news for you. I used to have some respect for you. You brought yourself up from the gutter, Handsome Jimmy, but you're obviously getting homesick. You're not going to be handsome after Billy Joe, Terrence Garvin, and the King get through with you, but he will be shouting what?
Mercy, Daddy. Mercy. Have mercy on me.
We ain't going to have none on none of you punks this week.
We're going to hurt you.
Now you can have the stars of the USWA in your hometown. It's America's number one fundraiser, USWA Wrestling. The stars, the action, the excitement, USWA Wrestling. For more information on how you can raise money for your organization, write the USWA, Post Office Box 1783, Hendersonville, Tennessee, 37077, or call 615-824-8523. USWA Wrestling, America's number one fundraiser. Now on USWA Wrestling, let's go to the Sportatorium in Dallas, Texas. Mark Lawrence is standing by. Robert Fuller, ready for action.
Robert Fuller in the ring with his beloved World Tag Team title belt, which he holds part of, along with Brian Lee of the Stud Stable. And here Robert Fuller goes against Big David Hinkle in our first bout.
I don't know who these Southern Rockers think they are coming in here trying to wrestle the Stud Stable. Robert Fuller and Brian Lee will make short order of these guys. You know what that means, Mark? Once they beat them to death, they'll be short order cooked somewhere at a Waffle House. That's what's going to happen when Robert Fuller and Brian Lee get a hold of them, buddy.
As I was saying, it is David Hinkle against Robert Fuller, who is agitating the crowd and pacing back and forth with his World Tag Team belt. Fuller still upset about the absence of Miss Sylvia, now saying that he will never, ever find her, and blaming the fans for part of his problem.
You watch how you talk about Miss Sylvia, okay? If Robert Fuller hears you saying her name down here, buddy, he'll be down here and get on you.
And Tinkle turned and backed into the corner. Fuller backs away with a clean break and a big grin on his face.
He's an honest man. See that? He shook his hand. That Robert Fuller's a Southern gentleman, buddy, and don't you forget that.
The referee stands. And it's Fuller turning Hinkle over with the arm drag.
You see that arm drag? This man knows how to wrestle. He's a sportsman. Look at that. He shakes his hand again. He's a true gentleman, Mark.
Fans buzzing about early bout action. Here's the referee stance in the center of the ring again. And this time, it's exactly the same move, but done by the other party.
I think he pulled his tights or his hair or something.
Fuller trying to get away. Hinkle trying to grab him, but since they're in the rope, Tony Falk.
I knew it. He pulled his tights. Robert Fuller just said he pulled his tights.
Trying the old handshake routine, and he wishes to shake hands and does so, and now we continue.
It's three times he shook his hand. He's a gentleman. Look at that headlock. Nice takedown by Robert Fuller.
Fuller with a headlock. One, and that's all.
I'm telling you, it's a breath of fresh air to see Robert Fuller out here wrestling. Oh, man. He plays by the rules. He does it just like you're supposed to do it. He gets out here and he wrestles.
Go ahead, Terrence. Keep going. For once you speak this,
you telling me what to do, Terrence?
Fuller with a shot to the rib cage. Fuller back in the corner, grabs him, throws him over in front of us, and Hinkle hits hard.
Nice boot. Boy, that was right in that chest. Snap mares him over, puts a boot right on the head, Mark. Oh, this is great. Nothing against the rules here, buddy. He whips him into the ropes. That is a foot.
Yes, big foot. Fuller, who stands about 6'4", can really raise that foot right up into the face of an opponent. He hooks the leg. There's one, there's two, there's three, and there's the match win for Robert Fuller of the Tennessee Stud Stable. All right, we send it back to the control room.
USWA wrestling all over the country. Now let's go to Memphis, Tennessee. The team that took the belts away from the Stud Stable in action. The Southern Rockers. Take it away, Dave Brown.
On their way up to the ring right now. I got the Southern Rockers.
Talking about a freight train. Did you see that one guy's face? That'd make a freight train take a dirt road.
Oh, come on. They're going against Keith, Eric, and Big O as we're set to go with tag team action here today.
I got news for you. I predict in this match right here that the Southern Rockers will be derailed like a freight train. Because Big O and Keith Eric are just the two guys that can do it, brother.
Well, you may be right about that. Keith Eric and Big O both have some pretty good wrestling credentials. Eric, one of those people that never backs up from anybody. Southern Rockers. Nice move by Rex King. Good drop kick. As Eric got back on his feet, Rex hit him with the drop kick, and Eric now still hanging back in the corner. and by some crazy stretch of the imagination, feels he had his height pulled.
I want you to watch these two guys in action. The Southern Rockers. You talk about you don't like to see the rules bent or broken. Look at this. You're not ever going to find two guys who more blatantly disregard the rules than these two guys. They double-team constantly. You watch, when one man tags, he'll hold his opponent until the other man gets the advantage on him. Watch this. There's a tag. Why don't you let him go? No. There's one man shooting him in. They both missed him. Look at this guy. that was a nice move, wasn't it? Huh? These guys are trying so hard to come out here and be fancy and do all of these fancy moves and impress these retarded fans over here that they can't do anything.
Just keep watching.
Yeah, you just keep watching the double teaming.
There's a tag by Keith Eric on Big O. Big O coming in to face Rex King of the Southern Rockers.
Okay, there's the tag. Why don't he let him go?
Now, wait a minute.
What? What do you mean, wait a minute, what? Now, is that a double team, Dave, or is my eyes, am I seeing double or what?
No, you're exactly right. That's okay. A double team. There's a count of two.
No, wait a minute.
Oh, almost had him, I thought, but Big O got that left shoulder up off the mat.
I'd be ashamed to take a win like that anyway if it took two men to beat one, wouldn't you? I guess that's about all they can do. They ought to be able to win some matches when it's two against one.
Well, they double up on the exchange, but then you notice Steve Dahl went right back out onto the apron, put a hand on the turnbuckle where it's supposed to be.
Could I ask you one question, Dave?
Sure.
Have you seen Keith Eric or Big O double team even once during this match? Even on the exchange, as you want to call it?
Well, they've only had one tag out so far.
Well, but did they double team it? No,
no, no, because Keith
Here's
has fallen over there.
The top rope. What? Man, oh man, what do you call that, Dave?
Count of one, two, three. I call that a victory for the Southern Rockers in 2 minutes, 31 seconds. Steve Dahl, Rex King, put the teamwork together, and they win it over Big O and Keith Eric, who are not happy.
That, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the top young tag teams to come down the pike in a long, long time. The Southern Rockers, they're after the USWA tag team belt held by the Stud Stable, and this week at the arena, no time limit, no disqualification, Stud Stable putting the belts up against the Southern Rockers. We'll be back for more USWA wrestling action right after these messages. The USWA presents wrestling action Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum. $1 off all tickets. Five great matches. Opening action, the Soul Taker takes on Ben Jordan. You'll see Wild Side Chris Champion against Rockin' Randy. Dirty Dutch Mantel takes on the Dirty White Boy. In a return, USWA Tag Team Championship match. No time limit, no disqualification. The match is signed for Evansville Wednesday night. The Stud Stable, Robert Fuller and Brian Lee, battle the Southern Rockers Steve Dahl and Rex King. Six-man tag action, a grudge main event. Jerry the King Lawler, Hot Property Billy Joe Travis, and the beauty Terrence Garvin take on Jeff Jarrett, Superstar Bill Dundee, and Handsome Jimmy Valiant. Plus, wrestling action March 4th, Princeton, Kentucky at the Caldwell County Middle School, and Thursday, March 15th in Cloverport, Kentucky. Don't miss the great action, Evansville Coliseum, Wednesday night, $1 off all tickets. WA Broadcast Center, one of the top tag teams. No matter when and where you put them together, they're a great team. Superstar Bill Dundee and simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett. They are hot. They've worked together before. We're going to see them in action right now. Mark Lawrence, if you're ready, take it away at the Sportatorium in Dallas.
Speaking of Jeff Jarrett, here he comes. Bill Superstar Dundee right behind, the man from the land down under. We're ready to see them in a tag team now. There's Jeff, there's Dundee. Jeff hollering at me about the big six-man bout coming up. He's ready for that right now, but he's going to have to wait a few days. And Jared and Dundee are ready for action. Is in the white shirt, being removed now, ready for the bout. And the Shadow is the masked man. Chris Allen and the Shadow, and it is Dundee against Allen to open up in this bout. Into the ropes, Dundee turns the big Allen over. And Dundee backing up what he said on the earlier interview. About 5'7", 205 pounds, and not a better 205, 5'7", anyway. Jarrett in to team with him on the double drop kick. And Allen is thrown yet another time, and Jarrett hits him over the hip with the arm drag. Great excitement here at the Sportatorium, seeing Jarrett and Dundee teaming together as the Shadow waits patiently with the mask. It's a fast-paced Jeff Jarrett in the second of it, taking the arm over the head, taking Allen down. Jarrett wastes no time in the ring. Tag for the Shadow. And Jarrett grabs that arm, throws him back into the rope, throws him far side, clothesline, and done. Jarrett with a tag on Dundee, and Dundee and Jarrett tag in and out with great regularity. And the Shadow having big time trouble. And a quick pin, one, two, and here is Allen over to distract Dundee. And now Dundee, I think, wants to remove the mask, or no, he's twisting the mask around where the Shadow can't see. There's a shot on Allen by Bill Superstar Dundee in the zebra-looking black and white. Stomp to the head. In the rope. The double throw. Over the shoulder twice. Jarrett and Dundee really putting on a great exhibition of tag team expertise. As the Shadow moves back in, a tag is made for Dundee. Jarrett finishes him off with a drop kick so that Dundee can move in. Jarrett stops the oncoming Chris Allen. Here's the Shadow thrown into a clothesline, into a sleeper. Sleeper now on the Shadow. Dundee's got it locked in. Jarrett keeping Allen out of the way. Tony Falk checking on the Shadow, and this bout is over. Dundee has put the Shadow to sleep. Great tag team win here for Bill Dundee and Jeff Jarrett. Mike, we send it back to you.
Back with you at the USWA Broadcast Center. Every now and then I get the opportunity to introduce a newcomer or a wrestler that you're familiar with already, and boy, have we got a superstar coming on board to the USWA. I'm talking about Handsome Jimmy Valiant, the Boogie Woogie Man, and he is coming on board here in the USWA. In fact, he'll be involved in a big six-man tag match along with Bill Superstar Dundee and Jeff Jarrett as they'll take on Jerry the King Lawler, the Hot Property Billy Joe Travis, and Terrence Garvin at the arena. But first, let's take an up-close and personal look at Handsome Jimmy Valiant.
Thank you.
One and only, no baloney, handsome Jimmy Valiant. Boy, what a wrestler he is. Let's take this break. More USWA action coming up next. You know, a lot of questions come our way on how do I become a professional wrestler. Well, superstar Bill Dundee has a special school to teach you how. Take a look. Attention, now's your chance to become a professional wrestler. Superstar Bill Dundee has details.
You know, every professional sport has somewhere where you can start real young. If you want to be a professional ball player, you can play peewee ball, go up into the major, the minor leagues, then you make it to the majors. You can play high school football, college football, and you hope you make it to the professional level. Well, if you want to be a professional wrestler like Jerry the King Lawler or Bill Superstar Dundee, Kerry Von Erich or Jeff Jarrett, you say, where do you go? Well, brother, up until now, there was nowhere to go. So if you want to go now, you just listen to what the man's going to say and call the number when he tells you on the screen, and he's going to tell you where is it. It's Bill Superstar Dundee's wrestling school. So if you want to be a professional wrestler, you write down this number, you call it, and I'll talk to you, give you all the details. So when you get the number, you call it, talk to me.
For more information, contact Superstar Bill Dundee at Post Office Box 1783, Hendersonville, Tennessee, 37077, or call 615-452-2167. I can see we're ready to switch to Memphis, Tennessee, and in fact, in the ring in Memphis is one of the graduates of Bill Dundee's wrestling school, and he's going to be a good one. Ben Jordan in action against the Dirty White Boy. Take it away, Dave Brown.
That's Ben Jordan in the ring right now, a young wrestler who has not been wrestling all that long, but has looked mighty good in several matches that we have seen. Oh, here comes Dirty White Boy, and he doesn't look all that happy. We are underway here with the opening match, Dirty White Boy going against Ben Jordan.
You gotta like Dirty White Boy's attitude. Oh, yeah.
Now, I don't like his attitude, but I do like his chances of winning the match, I must say. Whoa, yeah. Ben Jordan.
Hey, wait a minute now.
Well, I don't know. Maybe I don't like his chances quite as well. Look at Ben Jordan take the Dirty White Boy off his feet down to the mat. Dirty White Boy back up on his feet, though.
There you go.
Yeah, they're pulling
what?
Hair.
What?
Sure, there you go. Yanked him by the hair.
All he's trying to do is get his attention, Dave. You got this young punk come out here. Looks like he's full of spit and vinegar, and he's going to try to show off in front of all of these hairy-legged little girls over here. And all you got to do is you got to bang their head off that mat one time or two and get their attention.
Well, breaking the rules while you do it by yanking his hair. That's what Dirty White Boy did. There he goes again. Grabs him by the hair. Ben Jordan down on the mat.
Now, I'd like to ask you how you saw that. What do you got, the X-ray eyes or something?
No.
I'm sitting the same place you are. You could not see him pull any hair.
Well, I certainly saw him put his hand behind his head, and I saw that head snap back.
Watch it. I think I saw hair pulling there, did you?
I didn't see any. I saw a nice move by Ben Jordan. Look at that bar that he's got on the arm. Dirty, down. What's that? That was hair pulling. A couple of our young
fans here. Better question, what's that?
A couple of our fine young fans joining us today for USWA CWA Wrestling. Glad to have you with us. Got plenty of action scheduled for you.
You glad to have me with you? I know you are, Dave.
I know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about the folks who are watching on TV today.
Now, I did see a little hair pulling there, but it wasn't actually called hair pulling. That was just...
Wait. It was not called hair pulling? What was it?
He's using it to get a little leverage there.
All right.
What did you say? What is it? Ben Jordan been going to Bill Dundee's School of Wrestling, right?
Now, there again, a handful of hair. Dirty White Boy, that seems to be about the only way he'd get Ben Jordan off his feet, is grab him by the hair. There's
Ben
Jordan.
Dave, you know what? Have you ever been accused of being biased out here?
I've been accused of it, yeah.
Well, I'm here to tell you and set the record straight. You definitely are. You were against the Dirty White Boy the minute he walked in the ring.
Wrong.
I saw the look on your face. You didn't like him as soon as he set foot in there.
you knew in your mind that you were going to come out here and try to sway the public opinion in the favor of this punk Ben Jordan.
Absolutely wrong. I'm opposed to people who come out here and break the rules.
What about the fist there?
Look at Ben Jordan.
Oh, oh yeah, look at him.
Dirty white
like
boy.
Like a flying saucer, UFO.
Dirty white boy using that veteran
goodness.
Knowledge that he
boy,
has
that
from around
nice,
behind. There's a cover, one, two, and three.
Yeah.
I see Dirty White Boy ends up winning it.
And let's keep rolling it. Go to Dallas, Texas now, the Sportatorium. Take it away, Mark Lawrence.
Here comes Sheik Braddock. Skander Akbar moved Gaylord back up the aisle in time to get the Sheik. And he and Gaylord return for their bout. Jimmy Jack Buck and Dutch Mantell to be their opponents. As Gaylord screams at Oz Kovanar, Kaplan, to get him on television some more. There's Jimmy Jack Buck from Amarillo, Texas, part of that world-famous wrestling family. And Dutch Mantell not far behind from Horse Draw, Texas. Buck, look at your referee. We're ready to go after that wound-up and emotional conversation with Matt Lloyd. In his right hand, and Jimmy Jack Buck with that cowbell and rope, and Skander Akbar trying to get things in order so the bout can get underway. Here's Dutch Mantell. And Gaylord, who's angry with the crowd, is out on the floor moving around, screaming at the crowd. As the bell rings and Sheik Braddock will open up against Dutch Mantell.
Oh, beautiful, talented.
There's Gaylord. Gaylord not only has a big body, but also a big ego. And he gets that ego damaged very easily when he is not granted the respect that he thinks he deserves. Whisper something to Braddock, who is ready to go against Dutch Mantell. Headlock by Mantell. And the throw by Braddock. Shoulder butt. Another. Terrence Garvin terminated from television earlier by John Brazell of the USWA Governing Board. Mantell and Braddock. There's a drive by Braddock. Another trying to knock Mantell off. The throw of the rope. Surprise! It's a stomp to the head. Mantell continues. And a tag will be made, it appears. No, he won't. He just wants to rear that fist back. We'll be back for more of this exciting bout in a moment.
The USWA presents wrestling action Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum. $1 off all tickets, 5 great matches. Opening action, the Soul Taker takes on Ben Jordan. You'll see Wild Side Chris Champion against Rockin' Randy. Dirty Dutch Mantell takes on the Dirty White Boy. In a return, USWA Tag Team Championship match. No time limit, no disqualification. The match is signed for Evansville Wednesday night. The Stud Stable, Robert Fuller and Brian Lee, battle the Southern Rockers Steve Dahl and Rex King. 6-man tag action, a grudge main event. Jerry the King Waller, Hot Property Billy Joe Travis, and the Beauty Terrence Garvin take on Jeff Jarrett, Superstar Bill Dundee, and Handsome Jimmy Valiant. Plus, wrestling action March 4th, Princeton, Kentucky at the Caldwell County Middle School, and Thursday, March 15th in Cloverport, Kentucky. Don't miss the great action, Evansville Coliseum, Wednesday night, $1 off all tickets.
This Wednesday night, that's right, right down there at the Coliseum, it's going to be a big 6-man tag. And Jerry Lawler and Billy Joe Travis and the Beauty Terrence Garvin. Yeah, it's been a while since you've been there. Well, you're going to be facing 3 guys. 1, myself. Number 2, Bill Dundee. And number 3, Lawler. He can definitely out-talk you. Billy Joe, I guarantee he can out-sing you and Terrence Garvin. He can do whatever fruitcake, however fruitcake you want to get, he can get just his fruitcake.
That's right,
Bill?
That's right, Jeff. You know what else, too? It's still the February special. You still got a dollar off all the tickets. So the boogeyman's coming to town, brother. And whether he's singing, dancing, or fighting, it don't make no never mind to him. Well, let me tell you something, Billy Joe. The golden boy, you belong to him. Fruitcake, you belong to me. And Jerry the King Lawler, you know what the boogeyman can do, and I'm sure he's going to be boogieing all over you. But for whatever happens, 400 Court Street, Wednesday night, the roof's coming off. Jeff Jarrett, Bill Dundee, and the boogeyman.
Maniac Madborn is acting like a child or a young man just reaching the age of puberty. How stupid and naive can he be? And devastation thrives on no disqualification. And I can't believe that Matt Ford is asking for an ODQ match. Now, I don't care about Jeff Jarrett. Oh, I'll retract that statement. Jeff Jarrett is a great athlete. But you see, devastation is always one step further than the USWA. So you know what that means, Mark? Next week, you know what that means? It means that the general will be well prepared.
Speaking of deviant minds and big egos, Skandor Akbar is certainly one of those. A man possessed with attention, with money, with greed, and ethics mean nothing to him. He'll do whatever it takes to feed that ego and keep himself on top. Here's Jimmy Jack Fung now driving the shoulder of Steve Braddock into his knee. And there's a knee to the shoulder yet again. Akbar, described by many fans as really sick and deviant, who does not understand reason, but motivated by extreme greed and the quest for power. Jimmy Jack Funk with the armbar as Dutch Mantell is ready to chase Akbar away. And Gaylord comes down to his defense. Gaylord with that little stairway in hand, holding it up high over his head and threatening Dutch Mantell with that. In the ring, it's Jimmy Jack Funk with a bear trap around the neck and arm of Sheik Scott Braddock, the former U.S. Marine who sold himself out to the greed and offer of Skandor Akbar. It's Funk in charge. Jimmy Jack picks him up. Boom. Here's Dutch Mantell, the Lego Man, with an elbow, rebounding off the ring rope. Knee to the back. Mantell wants some of Gaylord. Look at this, Dutch Mantell trying to fake the tag and agitating in the process. And Gaylord, distracting the referee, allows a few shots from Mantell, and then a questionable tag that Gaylord and Akbar protest. Break it as Jimmy Jack continues on. Braddock needs to tag out.
Jimmy Braddock and Gaylord are fast becoming an invincible tag team combination. Those are two great worthy opponents of Jimmy Jack Funk, that low-down Texas punk, and Dutch Mantell, another Texas punk. Oil Trough, Texas. Well, he's going to find out exactly how we do Oil Trough, Texas, with devastation. I'm visibly upset, you see, because I want to prove beyond the realm of a doubt that Matt Bourne is not in the same class with a Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord.
Mantell thrown, and from the football starts to Jeff Gaylord throwing himself all around on the floor as Mantell darted out of the way just the right moment. Akbar wanting the bell sound, claiming it.
Qualified him automatic over the top rope.
But he wasn't thrown over the top rope. He just went over on his own momentum. That's no DQ. Mantell Bell now driven into the foot of Sheik Braddock, who tags with Jeff Gaylord. Double trouble for Mantell in the enemy corner. Slam, and Braddock stays right on. Could be, might be, but no. Akbar wanted the 1-2-3 there. He's wound up here on television tonight. Buck wants to come in to help his partner. It's a double gang up there. He's asked to leave. Mantell with a duck comes back. Double clothesline, left arm, right arm. Dutch Mantell somersaults over, makes the tag with Funk, and here we go. All 4 men involved. It's Bedlam in the ring. Akbar pacing back and forth frantically. Here's a pin, but the referee does not see it. There's 3, 4, 5. Gaylord in. Oh, no. Bronco Lovitz trying to get Mantell back in his corner, did not see what occurred. And Gaylord throws Funk over the rope. I think Bronco did see that. Signals for the bell to sound, and I guess all's well that will end well.
In the first, baby!
Winners of the match, Dutch Mantell and Jimmy Jack Funk. Brock missed the pin, but did see the over-the-rope, and that's a DQ that Akbar had been protesting about earlier. We send it back to you, Mike.
I got more wrestling action than I can handle. Okay, we were in Dallas. Now let's go back to Memphis. Dave Brown, Jerry the King Lawler in action.
It's just going to be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Lawler against Freezer Thompson. And as Lawler said earlier, this one was scheduled to go last week, but we got behind and things kind of got swapped around a little bit. So, whoa! Nice body slam on the King. Lawler found himself bouncing off the mat. I didn't see it. No, I didn't see any hair pulling at all. Referee didn't see any hair pulling, he said. Nope, no hair pulling. Thompson said, I didn't pull his hair. I don't think he did either. I think he just picked him straight up and slammed him. Thompson, Freezer out of Arkansas. Well, he's a big one. Weighs in well over 300 pounds. Lawler, going to try to whip him across the way into the turnbuckles, but Thompson won't move. A little trouble there, huh, King? Hey. Lawler, frustrated for the moment anyway. We're 1 minute into the action. Freezer Thompson backs Lawler into the turnbuckles in a neutral corner. And then grabs him and whips him across the way. Lawler bounces out of the turnbuckles. And Freezer Thompson looking good here. We're a minute and a half into the match. He didn't pull your hair. Tell you what. We could see hair pulling all over the place. And Dirty White Boy was yanking Ben Jordan's hair in the opening match. I think Lawler's definition is different from Myers or something. And now all of a sudden he's imagining that Thompson is pulling his hair. There's a reversal by Lawler, backs Thompson into the corner. Lawler snaps him up right in, and Freezer comes right back at him, and that rattled him. Lawler's claiming that he got hit with a fist, but he used an open hand. He followed the rules. He didn't break the rules. Well, all the crowd over there saying, you hit him with a fist. Lawler spending about as much time running his mouth in there as he is wrestling Thompson. Back on the ropes. Lawler. Across the ring, and then backdrop coming off of there. Lawler was wanting a complete break back on the rope. Now he said, hey, pull my tights, he pulled my hair, he gouged me in the eyes.
again, back on the ropes. Thompson again, whips him across the way, but this time Lola brings that boot up. Thompson tried it one time too many. If it worked once, many times going against a veteran like Lawler, just because it worked the first time. As a matter of fact, when it does work the first time, you almost guarantee it will not work again. You don't become the world champion without learning a few tricks like that. Lawler up on the middle rope. Look out, he's got that fifth double, and he smashes Thompson. This is probably going to do it right here. Count of two and three. He got him with a fist. He can claim it was open hand all day long, but you can see it as he nailed him with a fist. The time, 3 minutes, 30 seconds. Lawler wins. We'll be back.
Instead is continuing his torture and punishment on James Rapp, and now Jimmy James with the tag. Here's Billy Joe wanting the microphone.
I don't like you. I've never liked you. I'm about to kick your butt right now.
Tony Falk encouraging Billy Joe to get back in the ring, and it's the stance between these two. Out of the corner. James with the throw. Hits him and turns him over, and Billy Joe, very surprised and I think a little bit embarrassed. Terrence Garvin up on the apron complaining. Better there than here, I guess. That was indeed shocking earlier. Evidently, there was a terrible misunderstanding on the part of Max Andrews, John Brazell, and the board, but certainly I didn't have anything to do with the hiring of Terrence Garvin. Evidently, they didn't either. That really is a surprise. And here's Billy Joe taking James over into the boot and the knee of Hollywood John Tatum. Tatum is now the legal man in the tag. They both got Jimmy James. Look out! James taken down by both men. Hollywood Tatum picks him way up in the air, look out, and drops him over the ropes, nails him on the apron, and Jimmy James in a terrible shape. I thought for a minute he was going to suplex him all the way out on his back, all the way to the floor. Grief. Here's James Rapp in again, and Hollywood John Tatum picks right up where he left off on Jimmy James. Fans hear that one pop to the cheek. Tatum picks him up over the shoulder. Boom! Did he catch him on the knee or the head of the mat? Either way, it's a 1-2-3 win for Hollywood John Tatum. He and Billy Joe have won. Terrence Garvin and the other girls celebrate.
Michael St. John for the USWA. Hope you've enjoyed all the action today. Coming to the arena this week, listen to this card. In the first match, Wildside Chris Champion takes on Rockin' Randy. Dirty Dutch Mantel will take on the Dirty White Boy. The Soul Taker takes on Ben Jordan. Then a return USWA World Tag Team Championship match. No time limit, no disqualification. Stud Stable, Robert Fuller and Brian Lee take on the Southern Rockers, Rex King and Steve Dahl. In the main event, six-man tag action, and it is going to be a brutal battle, I can assure you. On one side of the ring, Jerry the King Lawler, the hot property Billy Joe Travis, and none other than the beauty Terrence Garvin. On the other side of the ring, listen to this, superstar Bill Dundee, simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett, and handsome Jimmy Valiant. You heard me right. What a card. Be sure to catch it at the arena this week. Catch USWA Wrestling next week right here on television. Until then, Michael St. John saying, so long, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.